What's up, you guys, and welcome to the rear sway bar installation. Long time coming. Little story on that we'll talk about later. As far as the centerpiece here, I have moved the TV over. It was over here, not a great spot. Relocated, then moved Shipik's WRX custom artwork that he made for me back when I had my WRX, one of my favorite cars of all time. My 2015 it was. Used to be up there, now it's over there. Got rid of some Hot Wheels that are hanging here because they're always in my way, annoying me, not letting me see what's on the shelf. And those got placed in nice little spots up here, as you can see, very, very beautiful. So this just gave an overall larger feel to it. Not so crowded with the TV kind of right in the middle. It's tucked back a little more, so I really love it now. Angled, I left my secret pick in the corner there for you guys, just for people that come up real close. So, I supposedly have my second set of end links coming today. These were the set that the original set I ordered was like last Wednesday. Wednesday. Supposed to come Thursday, as my rear sway arrived Thursday, I believe. Might have been Friday, but I think it was Thursday. So yeah, I thought it was out for delivery, that first one, and it just said delayed. It's been 3 days. The first day I saw that delay, I put in another order for two, separate order. Double hatch my bets, you know what I'm talking about. So now I had two orders in process, two times the chance of one. So I eventually did cancel the first order. There was no movement whatsoever. Even Amazon said, like, you know, click on this, refund. If it still arrives, you keep it, whatever. I don't think it will. So I said, cool, I canceled it. And now my second order is still on track. Now, doesn't mean I trust it at all. I'm not going to go all the way as far as stripping this thing out. I'll tell you about that in a sec. Until I have them, because I got a little sway bar link issue that I got to be careful with that I'll tell you about in a minute. These new tips that I fabricated, well, I wouldn't say that. These new tips that I massaged with my hands are the real deal. They have to be the finals for me. I'll take one minute to talk about tips, because you guys hate fondling these tips so much. So the black tips were probably my favorite overall, but they weren't exactly what I wanted. These are the black tips. Literally, and a sanding machine took all the black off. Now, I purposely left it kind of a road warrior-y kind of worn stripe kind of thing in the back, which I like. Reminds me of, like, remember the Monza, the orange and yellow twin exhaust you'd put on all your import four cylinders back in the late 80s. Of course, I had them. I even put one on my Z, which most people thought was dumb. I think my 280, my 81 280. Oh my God, I just washed this thing. Now I did take it for a spin. That's right. I got a little dust line on it. I swear to God, guys, this is definitely ceramic. Are you freaking kidding me? I washed it with a dirty sponge, a gritty sponge almost. I didn't put any effort into the wash, and it comes out like this, guys. This has to be ceramic. It doesn't have one spider web on it with the sun in it. I still think this car's ceramic'd. I don't know any way to prove it, but there is no way that this paint is this good for this long with me owning it. I don't go super crazy with double buckets. It has to be ceramic. So the first things I'm always thinking about when I'm about to take off my exhaust is disconnect my motors, or I'll destroy my wires. Disconnect your wires, drop it down. On the stock one, I usually just do the bolt there. On the AWE, sometimes I can slide the little rods out, but whatever. And the new method for the jack and wood has really changed my life. I did at least 10 of these swaps already without this, and just getting destroyed. I can barely lift these exhausts. Both of them are super heavy, and I finally just figured out, dude, let your tools work for you. And it isn't a perfect balance, but it works so much better. I never take it on my back anymore, lifting these up and down, because you know how often I love changing exhaust. All right, this cat-back's coming off right now. Try and show you what happened. I think it was Thursday before I knew that my end links weren't coming. And yeah, I hadn't really planned to do end links before, and then, you know, I was glad I did in the end. So yes, I did have the right tools. I did use the correct triple square in there, holding it, turning the nut, and the whole thing just split and cracked in half there. As it was coming out, one of them I think I did get off, but I ended up putting back on. So at this point I have two loose end links that, I mean, they're not loose, but they're definitely not tight, and I hear them clunk, and that's why I was in such a hurry to get these end links replaced. And it isn't a problem getting them out. I can just, you know, undo the bottom end link bolts, swing them up, whatever, and get the stuff out. I can definitely deal with it that way. So we'll look into the new speed instructions pretty soon. All right, guys, it's still freezing here, and I'm all scummified and having fun working on my car. So I just got notice on the Amazon tracking that at least it shows how many stops are away now. So now there's a 99% chance it's going to get here. At least it's like in the neighborhood. So I'm going to go ahead and proceed with taking off this sway bar real quick. It shouldn't take too long. So because of just all the messed up end links and everything, I'm just going to undo the bottoms here, and hopefully I can just swing those out somehow. And after I undo the frame stuff under here, which I already sprayed and loosened up, and it should be no problem at all to take out this sway. You can see it's almost completely clear the whole way. It's going to be super easy. Famous last words. Should be just about ready to come out. Oh my god, look at that. Look at that. Sick. Oh my god. Guys, take out your freaking cat back, and this is how easy your sway bar comes off. Freaking sick, guys. All right, let's take a look at some of the accoutrement for this OEM, downpipe. For this OEM sway bar, and let's check it out head to head next to the new speed one too. So first thing, we just check out all the stock bolts for the sway. That's it. So you got your bottom links on the left, sorry, and your framies here. This really should take 24 hours in this special rust bath. It is, you know, environmental safe and stuff, but it's not going to do a whole lot, but I figured I'd do something, and then I'll lube them up when I put them in. You know, they're not pristine. And as I only have a sander and not a wire wheel, I could have fixed those up. Man, I really should have got the wire wheel too. All right, I mean, maybe next time I can get that. Next, let's take a look at the carnage on these freaking end links that just screwed me. This isn't the one that's, well, it might be cracked actually, maybe not. This isn't the worst one, but this one was about to slip. This other side is the one that split. Let me hide the wind from you here. You can see this one split right in freaking half when I was trying to hold that pin in the middle. So that one, yeah, I can just cut this off and, you know, order two more and links if I ever need them for to have a set for each bar, you know. But let's go ahead and compare these now, head to head. Check it out. Big difference now. Off the top of my head, I believe the rear is 21 mil. The new speed is 25. You can definitely see the big difference here in burliness and beefiness. Huge difference. So this should be really awesome. Sweet that I don't even have to deal with these links here for now. You know, I'll take them off later sometime. But for now, I'm gonna be getting these on here. Gonna be connecting these sweet brand new Moog end links. I think it's the same part number for each one. I should get these on Amazon. This is the one that was delayed, and luckily this is the second set that I ordered, which is good. I may pump a little something in here. I don't like making a mess of it, but I'll probably pump them up a little bit before I forget. Of interest on those new speed directions with the torque. If you use the forward hole, you want to torque that end link at full droop, meaning with the wheels hanging. If you use the rearward hole, you then want the suspension loaded like I have it, which is very just about similar to, you know, a couple degrees off, but that's pretty much loaded right there. All right, this should be pretty easy. Let's see. Yeah, pretty easy. Let's get this one in. There we go. Got it started. With everything nicely lubed and wet, it's like going in nice. I don't want to drop this and dent it all up. Let me get over here. Here. Started. It's in there. It started. All right, try and get those top ones started. Yeah. Yeah, I got that started too. It'll just be hard to get in there. And let me get this top one over here. Also started. You just got to take the, you know, the weight off of it, and it can turn a lot easier with your finger, especially the top ones, which take forever to tighten if you use a wrench or something. I can almost get that top fully freaking flattened. Sick. Yeah, now it's just this one is a little bit back. All right, I'll turn off for a minute. You don't need to watch the whole thing. All right, end links, let's see. I'll go something like that, probably. Yeah, just like that. Clean off a little of the shrapnel from some of my grease pump. I did actually get some grease pumped into it, although I kind of need a new grease gun. I don't like the one I got. Take these nuts off for now, these sweet brand new nuts. Yes, I do have a thin, slim wrench for this specifically, as I put this end link on a lot of my cars. V-dubs, I should say. So first, we're gonna try getting this to fit. Oh, perks, that's cake, dude. Oh my God, forget about it. Forget about it. Just forget about it. Oh my God, by hand, it's done. All right. I guess I can put this on slightly. It's through the sway bar now, but just lightly. I got to make sure the other side gets on too with no issues. So then I can't wait. What I really can't wait for is to get that exhaust back on. Let me give you a little spin. Oh, I can't wait to get that AWE back on. It's been off for quite a while and the car just isn't the same without it. All right, where's my other two screws? Here they are. All right. Thank God, man, this thing has been creaking and having all kinds of problems because of my loose end length, those stock ones. Right, oops, that's not the right screw. Oh, that's for the big piece. Here it is. Okay. Yeah, that one will take a little bit of a wrench. It's not quite as smooth as the other one. All right, pull up the end link. Bend its little nut and see where we're gonna get this. Oops, I put it accidentally on the stiffer hole over here, which I did not want to do. So let me get it straightened out here. Take out one nut, pull this out. All right, guys, fair disclosure. It just took me a half hour to get all these nuts connected at once. It's just a really weird angle trying to get all this done. Now everything is finally locked in. I didn't give up, got frustrated, and then just, you know, took my time until I figured it out. So one thing, just for my tip, what I found, I had no luck doing this piece last because it would never get down there. It's so fine-toothed, perfect width that once you have it angled in any way at the top, you're never gonna get it in. So I first had to get this all the way perfect with the bolt through, and then I worked on the nuts and end links up here. Just had to kind of wiggle the angles. I did not use any hammers or channel locks. I just kind of pulled and pried in various directions till it just had a good angle, and then just squeezed it through, you know, just enough to get all those nuts on there. But it is a little tricky, you know, you gotta take your time on that. So the first thing we're gonna do here is we're gonna torque the frame brackets here, which say 20 Nm, which is the same as 15 plus a quarter or whatever. We know I'm not using new bolts or nothing like that. I'll just get an estimate of 20 Nm and I'll go ahead with that. 22 Nm locked in, frame bolts. Just enough room to get the top one. I guess I won't, I mean, I'm going 1 or 2 Nm more at pound, whatever. I'm not gonna go crazy on these because I do want these to be fairly accurate to allow a good twist in there, you know. I don't wanna over tighten it. So this is a rare case where I'll be pretty specific to torques just in case. Okay, top one. Okay, check them, but I'm not moving them. Okay, that's it, last two. Okay, and frame is done. This is a pretty easy install without that exhaust installed, isn't it? 35 foot-pound for the bottom. I'll do the same for the top, 35, just something close. If I can find the freaking bolt. There it is. Okay. That sure feels like a lot more than 35 foot-pound. Okay, it was probably close. Anyway, close enough on that. Okay, is that turning? Yeah, it is turning. All right, I figure. Okay. So you're saying, bro, how the hell am I gonna torque that? Ow! Ah, that's a shin into the ramp, so that's gonna hurt tomorrow. Crowfoot, Lexicon, or any of your choices. Start with it down, and then you can do your torques. And I do need to hold it, because I saw, is that bleeding? No, it just feels like it is. All right. Of course, I'm gonna get the right piece too. It's probably the wrong size here. It's working a little bit if I keep this still. Sort of like that. Of course, you gotta be all lined up. I need two hands. Just wanted to show you a way you can do it for a torque from something that's hard to get to. All right, guys, so we are all installed. For full disclosure, no, I did not get those torqued right. I just didn't have the right crow's foot, and I'm not worried about that. I just tightened them up by hand as tight as I could, pretty much like the bottom ones for the end lengths themselves. For me, the most important ones were those frame ones that we did torque properly. So yeah, ready to put my exhaust back on, finally get this car to what I've been dreaming about for like a whole week. It's gonna be insane.